I'm Vaishali. Good morning. This is my new video on the job sequencing. So this is the second last video. I'll be posting one more video after this. So in this, what I have discussed about the question, when the question will be a format of n jobs through m machines. Okay, when you have more than two number of jobs and you have more than two or three number of machines, what process you have to follow? Okay, so actually in this condition we have the two techniques. We'll just first discuss the techniques. What happens when you have more than when you have n jobs and m machines? Okay, first this is the given question. In this question, solve the following sequencing problem given an optimal solution when the passing is not allowed. Okay, so this is the jobs and this is the machines. So this is jobs, these are the jobs, and this is the machine, and this is the time taken by a particular job and a particular machine for processing. Okay, now first I have to start and explain you about the steps. The steps is what, in the case of n jobs through m machines, okay, the step by step will be start solving it. Firstly, you have to find the value of minimum of the time, okay, of the T1 time on the jth machine. That means you have to find the minimum of the time of the first machine. Okay, minimum of the time taken by the first machine. Then you have to find the minimum time taken by on the mth machine. So this is the mth machine. Okay, so and then you have to find the maximum time taken by the intermediary machine, that is the time taken by the second machine. So exactly what you have to find, so these are the jobs. Okay, A is a job which is processing time is M, processing time is 11 on the M1 machine. So you have to find the minimum time taken by A job on M1 machine. So which job is taking minimum time on M1 machine is 9. That is C. C job is taking minimum time on M1 machine. So minimum time taken, I'm writing just time, minimum time taken by M1 machine, that is on the job C. You can say job C takes minimum time on the M1 machine. Similarly, minimum time taken on the mth machine, we have the fourth machine as the last. So M4 machine, minimum time taken by which job? Which job is taking minimum time is the B job. B job takes only 8 hours on M4 machine. So I'll be writing this 8 hours is the minimum time taken. Okay, now for the intermediary machines, that means in between we have many machines, first and last. So between M2 machine, so maximum time taken by machine M2, which or processing of which job, that means the processing of which job, that means so 4, 3, 5, 2, so E job is taking maximum time of 6 hours in on M2 machine, comma, then next M3, 6, 7, 5, 8. So, D machine is taking maximum hours on M3 machine. Here we have only two machines as an intermediary machine. If we have more number of machines like 5 or 6, so you have to write the more number of machines. You have to compare more number of machines. So, maximum time taken by which machine is the 8 hours. Okay. Now, by getting these three, we have to apply the step number 2. In the step number 2, so we got this. Okay, I hope step 1 is clear to you. Moving to the step number 2. In step number 2, we have to check the inequalities. Okay, now the minimum of the first machine should be greater than maximum of the intermediary machine. This is the formula. Now putting the values here, I'll just checking it here. So the first inequality is minimum of T1j, that is the time taken by the first machine for a particular job, max of j and tij. Ji is 2, 3, so on for the intermediary machine. Okay, so minimum of T1, minimum of for T1, that is time taken by the first machine, M1 machine is 9. 9 is greater than equal to, the intermediary machine is 8. Yes, 9 is greater than equal to 8. 9 is greater than 8. So first conditions are satisfied. So this is fine. Now moving to the next condition. In the next condition, it is given that minimum of TMJ should be greater than or equal to max of J, TIJ, and J again, I is the for the intermediary machine. So check this one. Yes, minimum of TMJ for the last machine is an M4. Minimum time taking it by it is 8 hours. Okay, that any job is taking the minimum time on the M4th machine is 8 hours. This is greater than equal to the 8. Yes, this is equal to 8. So this condition is also satisfied. So in our case, in the given question, both the conditions are satisfied. That means both the inequalities is satisfied. So this is the step number 1 and this is the step number 2. I hope these two steps is clear to you. This is the step number 2. Okay. Now after getting the step number 2, step number 1 and step number 2. Now process to the step number 3. If the above inequalities are failed or not satisfied, the method fails. That means which method we are applying will not be applied. That means we are going to apply the same Johnson's method which we are applying on the first video. Okay, on the first part. So that method will not be applicable in case of the when the both the inequalities is failed. That is clear to you. Now if method is not failed, that means if any of the inequality get satisfied. Now step number 4, if both or any of the inequalities satisfied, then convert the M machine problem into 2 machine problem. Okay, now considering how we can convert this M, that means 4 machine problem into 2 machine problem, there are also 2 criterias how we can convert them, how we can convert them into 2 machine problem. Okay, there are the 2 ways, first way and the second way. First way is you have to see if the sum of the intermediary machines, the time taken by any process, the time taken by these jobs on an intermediary machines is a constant value for every column, you can say. Like here we have 4 plus 6, 10. Here we have 3 plus 7, 10. 5 plus 5, 10. 8 plus 2, 10. 6 plus 4, 10. Okay. Then the part 1 arises. If we have the sum of intermediary machine, the time taken by intermediary machine is a constant value. In that case, we will be taking M1, the first machine, and the last machine as the 2 machine. Case, okay, we'll be taking M1 and M2 as the 2 machine problem and we'll be just leaving this constant value aside. Got it? If T2, T3, that means time taken by the second machine, first machine on a particular job, so on, is a constant, a fixed constant, then determine the optimal sequence for the 2 machines by taking first and the last machine. Okay, so I hope this second point is clear to you. So we'll be taking this as a case because in our case the intermediary machine has a constant time value. Okay, so we have to take M1 machine and M2 machine under consideration for obtaining the optimal sequence only, but for obtaining the elapsed time we have to use the full values. Okay, now modified matrix is, now we have to make a new problem. That means M1 machine, that is 11, I have just copied it here, 11, 13, 9, 16, 16. Clear? Now for this M2, that means M4. Okay, so I will be writing it here, M4, if you have any problem. I will be writing it here, M4. You can write any name, kuch bhi de sakte hain aap isko. I will be writing M4, I have copied the same. Under A, I have written 15, so it is 15. Under B, I have written 8. This is 8. Under C, I have written 13. This is 13. Under D, I have written 9. This is 9. Under E, I have written 11. So, this is 11. So, now I hope this is clear to you. So, this is the new 2 machine and nth job problem. For this, you have to obtain the optimal sequence. So, you know, for the optimal sequence, we have to apply the same technique which we are doing from the in previous videos. So, what we have to do, you have to find the minimum of M1 here. and you have to write from left to right, and you have to write minimum of M4 from right to left. I hope this is clear to you. So now obtaining the minimum of M1, for minimum of M1 we have 9. So after obtaining the 9, just cross out this. Okay, write C here, because the C job take minimum time on M1. Now from the remaining you have to find the minimum of for M4, that means 8. That means for B job, write B job here, cancel this row column. Now from the remaining you have to find the minimum for M1, that is 11, that is A. So I'll be writing A here, cancel this column. Now for M4, the remaining is 9 and 11. Out of 9 and 11, that means the job D and E, minimum time taken is by D job. So write it here, D job. Okay, so then cancel this column, only one E is left, that will be occupied here. So optimal sequence we obtain by the help of this modified matrix. Now after this we have to do the same process for elapsed method that we have done in my last previous videos. That means for elapsed method we have to use the same full problem. That means all machines will be considered, because in this problem we have the 4 machine case. So we only converting the nth machine case to the 2 machine case, the concept is only to obtain the optimal sequence. Clear? So that we can apply the Johnson's rule for obtaining the optimal sequence. I hope that is clear to you. Johnson's rule to obtain the optimal sequence. So now we obtain the optimal sequence. Okay, now go to the full question. Okay, now starting with the total elapsed time. In the total elapsed time, what we have to write in the first column? We have to write the optimal sequence of the jobs. So optimal sequence of the jobs is this. C, A, E, D, B. That is C, A, E, D, B. Okay, so this is the optimal sequence. On behalf of the optimal sequence, I have made the columns for the 4 machine, 1 machine, then 2 machine, then 3 machine, and then 4th machine. In the same, I have written the idle time, then processing time, time in and time out. In maximum book, they have only given time in and time out. But I feel sometime in many questions and many videos, they have made the false calculating idle time. So it's better you can make 4 columns. And that is as per your choice in which you are convenient to. Okay, so I am writing in this way. So now start writing it here. So processing time, you know that these are the processing times of the machines for the jobs. So I'll be copying it here. Like for M1 machine, the processing time for C job is 9. Okay. Now for C job, the processing time for M2 machine is 5. So this is the processing time, this is 5. Now for C job, the processing time for M3 machine is 5. Processing time for C job on M4 machine is 13. So I hope the remaining you can write it. So you can skip that. This I have written. So see, I have obtained the processing time of all the machines. I have written under the columns of M1, M2, M3, M4 and in front of these machines. So after obtaining this, you have to only find the idle time, time in and time out, by which you can find the total elapsed time. Now start writing the value. So idle time for M1 machine is nothing, because we have to start the working on M1 machine. So at 0th hour we start, and till 9 the processing will be proceed on the M1 machine. After processing till 9 hours, okay, again at 9 hour for 11 hours, that means 9 plus 11 is 20, till 20 hour it will be processing the A job. Okay, now for the third, at 20th hour it is free, that means at 20th hour we can start for processing of E machine. So that we can start processing of E job, that means 20 plus 16 is 36, till 36 hour we are processing only E job. Okay, now 36 plus 16 will become 52. So till 52 we are processing the D machine. I hope this is clear to you. Every time we are copying it here, because this is the first job and we are adding the processing time of a particular machine plus the time it, so that we know what is the time out for this machine. Okay, this I have explained in my previous videos as well. I'll be sharing the link below. So at 52 hour, I start the work for B job on M1 machine. So till 13 hours, it is only processing the B job. So what we'll get 5, and this is 65. So 65 hour, at 65th hour, the M1 machine will get free. Okay, now M2 machine will start processing parallelly. So till 9th hour, the C job is processing on M1 machine. So at 9 only, means at 9 or after 9 only, it can start processing of C job, because now C job is free at 9 hour. So idle time for M2 machine will become 9. Okay, so 5 plus 9 is 14 hour. Till 14 hour, M2 machine is working for C job. Now at 14 hour, it get free, but here still A job is processing on M1 machine till 20 hours. So 20 minus 14, so 6 hours it has to wait. Okay, after 6 hours, when it is 20th hour, it can start processing for the A job. Till 24 hours it is working. Now at 24 hour again it is free, after 24 hours, but still E job is processing on M1 machine. So 36 minus 24, that means 12. For 12 hours it has to do the waiting. After waiting of 12 hours, that means at 36th hour it will obtain the E job to process. So 36 plus 6 is 42. Till 42 hour, now it is processing the E job. Okay, at 42 hour it is free now, but still the D job is processing on M1 machine. So 52 minus 42 is 10 hour. So till 10 hour it is having the waiting time. Okay, for the search of D job. So 10 hours it is still idle. At 52 hours it starts working. So this will become 54. 54 is a timeout for the D job. Now still 65 hours this B job is processing on M1 machine. So 65 minus 52 is 13 hours. Again 13 hour waiting is for the M2 machine. Okay, for getting the job B. So 65 I will start the work on M2 machine. So 3 hours it has to process. That means till 68 hours it works for the B job. A lot of waiting time is given for M2. Fine. Now moving to M3. So M3 also will process the same. So idle time till 14 hours the work is going on M2 machine for job C. So job C only will be obtained by M3 at 14 hours. That means 14 hours ka iska waiting hai. For 14 hours it is waiting. Now time in is also 14. 14 plus 5 is 19. 19 is the timeout for M3. If you want, you can skip the between. I'll just do it in a quick. So 19 hours it is working, while 24 hours the A job is processing on M2. So that means 24 minus 19 will become 5 hours. So 5 hours is waiting for M3. So the same, at 24 it will obtain the A job to process. 24 plus 6 hours it done a processing. So 30th hour is a timeout for M3 machine. 30 minus 42 again is 12. 42 is greater than 30. So you can understand by this also E job is processing for 42th hour. So 42 minus 30 is 12 hour. So 42 will be time in for M3. So 42 plus 4 is 46. 54 minus 46 will get, okay, 8 hours is the time. Now the 8 hour is the waiting time for M3 machine for job D. So at 54 it starts work. So 54 plus 8 is 62 hour is the working time. Now it is now start waiting for the job B to start processing, but still 68th hour B is processing on M2 machine. So 68 minus 62 is 6 hours. At 68 hours it obtain the B machine and process for 7 hours. At 75 hours it is free. Completed this table. So 83th hour the M4 machine will be free. Now we have to obtain the total elapsed time. What is the total elapsed time? 83 hours is the total elapsed time. Total elapsed time is 83 hours. If they will ask you the idle time, So idle time for each machine you have to find. For M1 machine, idle time we don't have. In intermediate idle time we don't have, but at the last the machine has to wait. That means 83 is the total elapsed time. So idle time for M1 will become 83 minus 65. So you can obtain it and ask. Okay. Similarly for M2, this is the idle time as well as the at the last also. So idle time for M2, if they will ask you, in my question they have not asked you. This I have already explained in my previous videos very well. So idle time will become this also, the sum of this column. Okay, 9 plus 6 plus 12 plus 10 plus 13. So it will become 9 plus 6 plus 12 plus 10 plus 13. After this, you have to add 83 minus 68. So this will become the full idle time for M2 machine. So I hope this question is clear to you. Okay, so post your query in the comment box below. Do well, work hard, make your future. Okay, so please like, subscribe and share my channel. Thank you.